Hey guys, what's up? Thanks so much for stopping by. In today's video, I thought we could just do this glam get ready with me because why not? I was going through organizing my palette drawer and just got really inspired by the Tati Beauty glitter row. I love these glitter shadows so much. Honestly, I love anything glittery and I haven't really played with this one in a while. When I first got it, I was using it nonstop, but I've talked about this many times how once I get in the habit of using one product as much as I love it, I try my best to kind of rotate it and use other things. That way my other makeup doesn't feel lonely and neglected. So this one was kind of put to the back burner for a bit and I definitely fell right back in love with it. So yeah, go ahead and grab your makeup if you haven't gotten ready yet or if you just want to grab a snack and hang out with me. Let's do this. All right, so I am going to start off with the Too Faced Hangover. What is it exactly? Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray. Normally I just use it for a setting spray, but within the last few weeks I've been using it for both what it's actually intended for, and I guess it's just a nice little refresher. But for my true primers, I'm going in with my ever so faithful Laura Mercier primers. So let's do the Illuminating one first, just all over. I just finished watching Jackie Ina's Get Ready With Me morning routine, and I know for a while she's been doing primer and then the translucent setting powder all over and then foundation. I always want to try that, but I always like more of a hydrating, dewy feeling on my skin. I know she has a little bit more of an oily skin type, so I think it's intended more for that. Although I've been seeing people, I deleted TikTok. I don't know. I felt like all the TikToks that were coming up for me were like really lame. Even after I went and searched cooking things, I just didn't really care about the dancing type of TikToks. But Laura kept telling me, no, you need to watch it. There's like great cooking hacks and stuff. But anytime I went and clicked, I was only getting the dances and I don't know, just wasn't really for me. But I did notice on there, a lot of people were doing that hack with primer, setting powder, and then foundation and saying like how much of a flawless finish it creates. And I know Jackie had mentioned that too, but I don't want like a matte finish, and maybe it doesn't always have to be super matte. I don't know, but maybe I'm just stuck in my ways. We'll test that for another day whenever I'm okay with having more of a possible matte look. So that was just the blurring primer. I just like to go in on the sides and on my forehead. I did see a couple comments asking if I prefer the Tatcha one more or this one. Honestly, I'm not sure. They both do such a great job at just really going in and blurring the pores and smoothing things out. I do think that the Tatcha one might be slightly more smoothing, but I think the Laura Mercier one feels lighter on the skin. Both are good. You really can't go wrong either way. I decided to pull out my Tati palette. Whenever I think of something ultra glam, this is definitely the palette that comes to mind, and I haven't used it in a while. When I first got it, I used it nonstop, and so I just forced myself to push it back for a wee bit. But I do think I wanna go in with like a really dark black with some sort of shimmery smoky eye. So for the base, I'm gonna go in with the Smashbox Photo Finish Lid Primer. This one is in Smoke. And I think I'm just, oh. I had this one brush that I absolutely loved for cream products and now I can't find it. I think this one from Profusion will work though. I think this came in some sort of like holiday palette set, but just to create, I have this painful underground zit right here. Anytime I bump it, I'm just like, ugh, wincing in pain. Also, I don't know how many of you guys have been keeping up with Desi Perkins' vlog channel, but she's been vlogging her fertility journey. And I'm sure many of you guys follow her on Instagram and saw that she announced her pregnancy. I cried when I saw that. Like, I've been so invested in those vlogs and I know infertility is so tough and just watching them go through all of that and finally be pregnant, I'm so happy for them. Obviously, I don't know them in real life, but I mean, anyone getting pregnant after trying so hard, I get to see my mom tomorrow and you guys, I'm so excited. I can't even begin to explain. Obviously, I always miss her, but during this quarantine, it's been even harder having them so far away. I just feel like even if I couldn't see them, but if they were like 5 miles away, just knowing that they were closer would make it a lot easier. But with them being 10 hours away, 10 hours when it's like bad traffic, I think actual time is right under 9 hours. But when they're that far away, it's hard. It makes me miss them even more. I know I shouldn't complain because there's other people whose parents live even further away or people who don't have their parents with them anymore. And I apologize for anybody in that situation, but man, I'm just so excited to see both my mommy and my dad. Now I'm just gonna go straight into Memory. If you guys still haven't picked up this palette, the black in here is so, so pigmented. You literally need the tiniest doink in that pan. If you get too much, it's just an intense black right away. But I really like the formula because it's one that blends out nicely. I think this black and then the Makeup Forever, or not Makeup Forever, Makeup Geek. What was that shade called? Ooh. Keegan and I just started watching Outer Banks today. I've had it on my Netflix list after we finished All American. I was like, I just want another sort of feel good type of teeny bopper show. And the first episode was good. I like it. I'm definitely already hooked, so I'm excited to watch more. If you guys have any other show recommendations, definitely let me know down below. I still haven't finished the other seasons of Ozark. Keegan had watched one on his own a while ago. I don't know. I guess at the time whenever it first came out, I just wasn't that interested, or I must have been watching something else. So I watched season one by myself, and then he was like, okay, we'll wait for season two with me so then we can watch it together. So we have that to watch too. I still haven't watched more of that Last Kingdom show that I had mentioned, so I need to get back on that. Also, I made my first vlog live today. I don't know why I was so nervous to upload it. Hopefully you guys like it. It was just kind of a hodgepodge of everything, so we shall see how that goes. If you guys are curious on my nails right now, I'm wearing one of the new light slacker polishes in Mila. I love this color. It's just a really nice kind of like creamy, super light beigey shade. It's really pretty. I'm obsessed with Kathleen's niece, Mila. She is so cute. I've messaged her before and told her something about that little girl reminds me of the, what are they called? The Chipettes, the chipmunks, like Alvin, Simon, Theodore's girlfriends. She just has the biggest eyes and like her lashes and her little baby teeth. She's so cute. Anytime Kathleen posts stories with her, not to sound like a creep, but I rewatch them at least 3 or 4 times just because like her chubby cheeks, I can't even handle it. What I love about these glitters is I don't have to go in with a second product. Obviously, if you really want to ensure that it stays in place all day, you could go in with some sort of glitter adhesive, but I don't have any problem just popping it right on without anything. So it just makes it really easy. So just taking my finger, I'm just going to pack this all over the lid. What is it about black and glitter? This instantly starts to look like a New Year's Eve look to me, but I'm okay with it because this is what I was going for, I guess. I don't know why, I was just bored and I was like, I just wanna do something a little bit more glam and high coverage today because why not? Okay, so there is the glitter. I think I do wanna go in and just create a tiny bit of a shadow wing. One of my favorite brushes for that is the Inglot 31T. I really like to use this brush though, just because it's really nice and stiff. So you can create a nice crisp line. All right, so I went ahead and popped on some lashes. I think I should have trimmed this side a little bit more, but they're glued on now. I'm committed. I'm just gonna deal with it. These are the Makeup Geek 3D Faux Mink Eyelashes in the style Ava. I had to trim quite a bit off the edges, so I thought that was enough. Apparently not, because they're still long, but like I said, we're committed. Also, I just wanted to give a heads up. If you're also a huge fan of the Essence Lash Princess Waterproof Mascara, don't even bother with these. I was hoping maybe since it was also a waterproof formula, it would be good. It's not even that I hate the brush, it's a chubbier brush, but the formula just isn't close. It separates my lashes, but nothing holds my lashes up quite as well as the Lash Princess. Other mascaras that I love, like the Lancôme Monsieur Big, but I didn't want to pay for another high-end mascara. I typically always love Maybelline waterproof mascaras too, so maybe I'll just have to go to Target and do that because Ulta didn't have this available for curbside pickup, which makes me real sad, but it'll do. I'm gonna take some of the Jouer lip oil. I really like this stuff. Okay, this is totally random, but I need to know if any of you guys have seen this movie. I was talking to my friend the other day and she decided to start showing her kids. She's basically burnt out of Frozen. That's all that her kids have been watching. And so she was saying how she wanted to show them other movies, like older cartoon movies, but not Disney ones. So I was talking about Anastasia, Fern Gully, We're Back, The Dinosaur Story. And she's like, oh yeah, those are great. Troll in Central Park. There's kind of like a Snow White spinoff. I can't remember what that one, Ever After maybe. Let me know if you guys have seen this one. She did know what I was talking about with that, but then I was like, Little Nemo. And she was like, do you mean Finding Nemo? And I was like, no, Little Nemo. And then I decided to ask a few other people about it and nobody knew what I was talking about. I'm pretty sure my parents got me this VHS when we lived in Okinawa. It may have been like a dubbed movie or something because the animation definitely does look a little bit Japanese. Something about it just looked a little bit Asian. But I had a pretty extensive VHS collection as a kid. This is just the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Dewy. I can't put this foundation down. It's just perfection, okay? And it's super affordable. And if you haven't tried it and you like Dewy foundation that's really comfortable on the skin, you need to try it. Anyways, I was telling her just be kind of careful because it is a little bit creepy. It's one of those movies that I remember loving but being scared of. I don't even know how to describe it. There's parts that I remember. It's not a Christmas movie, but this kid goes off on his bed into some other dreamland thing. So it's almost like a dark version of Polar Express. But there's just weird characters. And I don't remember if it was like the Nightmare King or just his bad guys. I haven't seen it in years. I want to find it online somewhere. I'm tempted to rewatch it, but I just remember there being really creepy parts about it. I've mentioned this many times before in the past, whether it's on my channel or on Instagram stories. Anytime I mention anything disturbing or something about a scary movie, I have to mention this. How many of y'all watched Watership Down as a kid? That movie is absolutely terrifying. I remember every Friday night after my dad got off work, we were living on base, Kadena in Okinawa. He would take me to, it wasn't a Blockbuster. It was just the on base version. I don't even remember what they called it, movie something. And he would go get a movie for him and my mom. And then I would always get to pick out my own movie and watch it in my room. And I had picked Watership Down and my dad looked at the cover and was like, yeah, that looks fine. The cover is cute. It's like bunnies in a field. It's absolutely terrifying. It caused me to sleep with my parents for months. Netflix ended up doing their own version, like a remake of it with weird animation. And I watched the whole thing because I just had to know if it was just as scary. It definitely still was creepy, but not as scary as the original one. I've been using this a lot lately. I talked about it in an underrated video. I know I used it in a Get Ready With Me video too, but I've been really, really liking it. And since I've been using the Too Faced one for so long, I think I was just excited to go in and use something different. This is just the Pony Effect Pro Fit liquid concealer. I'm using the shade beige on my lid, mainly just like on the inner half. I ended up going in, oh, it didn't break, with the glitter shade in the Aura column. It's almost like confetti. It's really pretty. And I just felt like it added a little bit more to just the plain silver. You know what? While this concealer is setting, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with the Physicians Formula Sculpting Bronzer. I had picked this up on a recent Target haul. I did a Target haul try on where I just picked up a whole bunch of drugstore makeup that I've been curious about. And I've really been enjoying this bronzer. I'm mad at myself for taking so long and trying it. That may have been a little bit much on the neck, but you know what? There's a lot of double chin there to cover. Also, the foundation or concealer, it's a foundation brush, but I like it for concealer on my chin and my forehead. This is the Smashbox Fullest Full Coverage Foundation Brush. I know the Smashbox brushes are pricier, but I have to say they're really, really nice. This one, the powder brush, and then the blush brush. You guys pretty much see me using those all the time on my channel. They're just really nice brushes. For my cream bronzer, you should know by now, I like to use the Ultimate Blending Brush from e.l.f. I do need to just pick up a second one. They're only $6, but I really like to use it with cream blushes as well. So I would like to have a second one just to have one dedicated for bronzer and then one dedicated for blush. If you're curious about my earrings or any jewelry you guys see me wear, I always share it on stories, but I just recently posted a jewelry collection video where I just went in talking about all my favorite pieces, how I layer them, where I purchase them, some like little organizational pieces that I have, and then going in with Mist 5000 of the Too Faced spray. I haven't used these on camera yet, but I've really been liking them. I've kind of heard mixed reviews. I don't know if it's just because I didn't go quite as heavy-handed. A lot of people were saying that they could really feel an intense cooling for a long time. There is supposed to be a cooling effect because it's supposed to plump your cheeks. I personally haven't noticed a plumping effect, but I do really see a smoothing effect on my cheeks. Like I said, I think it's because I've been going in with such a light hand that I haven't felt the full-on like tingly feeling. But these are the Grande Cosmetics Grand Glow and Grande Pop Plumping Liquid Blush and Plumping Liquid Highlighter. So for the blush shade, I'm gonna go in with Cinnamon Sugar. It has this large doe foot applicator, and the first time that I went in with it, I went straight onto my cheeks and a sponge. And it kind of got a little, I don't know, wonky. Better method for me personally is to dot it with my fingers and then just go in with the sponge right away and start blotting it out. I don't know if you just go in with a doe foot applicator, it just seems to go on a little bit too heavy because the applicator holds a lot of product. I find that cream blushes that kind of have a thinner formula like this just last on my cheeks way longer because my cheeks, that's definitely the area where my makeup fades off the quickest. So for instance, the Flower Beauty blushes, the NARS liquid blushes, I just really like those formulas. I do find that these and the NARS ones tend to be a little bit longer wearing than the Flower Beauty ones. As much as I love the Flower Beauty ones, something about this and the NARS seem to be a little bit more pigmented and have this just sort of staining effect. Then I do have three of the highlighters. I've only tried one of them so far, and the shade that I tried before was Gilded Rose whenever I was self-tanned. Bronze Beam, but then French Pearl looks like it's the lightest, so I think I'm gonna go in with this one today. And just like with the blush, I'm gonna apply it on the back of my hand. Brush, just, ooh, that is pretty though. Okay, hold on. And then just tap it into, this is really pretty. This is my first time using this shade. Maybe we will just go into the sequin row and take Ritual. Okay, I think I like that more. I'm just gonna take a tiny bit of Metallic Aura and tap that into the inner corners. For lips, I'm gonna start off with the Makeup Forever lip liner in number 12, and then I grabbed two MAC lipsticks. I don't know if I wanna go a little bit more brown. Oh, this is a lot pinker than what I thought. Actually, wrong lip liner. Let me grab another. I think this ColourPop one's a better option. I think I'm gonna go in with MAC Yash, and then I do want glossy though. I don't think I want matte. We could keep it really nude with a gloss, but I thought we would go in with something shimmery. So this is Smashbox Gild. I just think for a really juicy look, this will be a pretty combo. All right, y'all, so here is the final look. Like I said, I was just in the mood to do something a little bit more glam. I would love to hear what you think of it down below. I'll definitely be getting more use out of this lip combo. I thought Yash and then, what was it, Gild went really well together. Typically, I go in with... it's not Hollywood Boulevard, Sunset Boulevard maybe, but this is a color in the packaging. It looks like it would be more of like a metallic-y golden coral, but on top of a nude lipstick, it's actually really nice. So I think this might be something that starts to live in my everyday makeup bag. But yeah, as always, thank you so much for hanging out. If you guys would like to see more of these just random get ready with me videos, definitely let me know down below. Thanks so much for spending part of your day with me, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.